Un Iran.
Sì?
Un Iran. Dove fa? Poi
Sono contento.
a Nagutova na Pakistan.
Harivanga ongo bukari to lead mission see. They are very few. Only two. How many are we expecting to have? Hello? Baba andi numvaga bavuga baragiye.
Na umvaga bavuga baragiye.
Babiri baragiye.
Na bona numwe dufite.
So bona muntu wari.
Na muntu wari. Cyatuye uko. Ndaje gatuye ku Ivano tukayitwaye schedulering.
Murambwirwa mu mwanya ko nabona saa 12 n'igicoro rugezageze. Sakumi nebye nyicho ndabona zageze uri yo direye aba uri cyo ngona bona hana bari bari nabo inkawe yayo ariko the way I want to approach this one yini module mu byukuri iri very vast copy arinze n'izindi modules uko nakunze kuyibona nubwo tuvuga gutanga tip approach the numbers ikibazo abantu bashobora kukibaza mu buryo bwinshi butandukanye. So the way I preferred to approach this one, byari ukubaha brief theory about it, atari ngombwa ko byose byandika, then abahana interpret kuko where they suffer, bakunda gusafarenga ko hari kiza kitwa like pure mathematics, sometimes abizi ni bo baba babizi, ariko noneho akaza n'ikintu bita interpretation of those findings or results in the context of business or economics, for example. So what I preferred now, theory in pure mathematics, when we are finding this one, now in the context of business or economics, we are trying to find this one. Kugira ngo bashe kumva the interpretation. So basigara n'ikibazo cyo gukora exercises. So bishatse kuvuga ko the way I want to approach this one, byarwa ngo na picking some question papers, some number from past papers, ikibazo yenda topic turimo kuganiraho, mbe nabahaye brief theory in words, bakurikira gusa. Ushaka kwandika yandika wenda mbahe dukeya mutwo bagomba kuhora bibuka then korane ndebe what they are trying to find tugira zibuna gukora interpretation tukiveho ariko bo bagomba kuzakomeza gukora nibindi bishoboka then when they face difficulties they can even contact my system so nkuvuga ngo na saa 50 ndavuga ngo ni byiza ko haba huko jewe na afata umanya ni ibura na meetinga na kwa like 3 times. Of course, na hachi unaba charging. It is just for the purpose of enabling them to have some basic understanding in terms of these tips. Noneho bagakomeza gukora exercises baje bagira ikibazo naba link baje bambarizaho then nkajya mbafasha igihe bagize ikibazo bageze ku bibazo bitandukanye wenda nibyo bagiye bakora uko umuntu ashobora kuhindura mu buryo butandukanye then bakambaza nkaba naba abashaka gukomeza kubona ubufasha with time aba nabafasha kugeza ubwo bazajya mu kizamini bafite nibura wabashije gushaka gukomeza gukurikira yakaba yajyamo bajya bahindura n'ibibazo akabasha kuba yakumva ibyo bamubajije n'ibyo yakagombye kubasubiza. Niyo mpamvu gene navuze ko kuvuga ngo amasaha atatu nayakoresha fine ariko gene numvaga nifuza ko nareba uburyo gene nakomeza kuinteractinga nabo kugira ngo ndusheho gukomeza kubikwepinga kubaha kuko ibibare isaba ibintu bitandukanye irabanza gusaba some theory behind sometimes batandafite. It's an example if you are sharing my screen, if you are looking at my screen, na here you could function is in chapter yambere na you could introduction to financial. Ariko tuvuge nk'urugero iyo bahereye nka kire kibazo nka quadratic for example ugasanga umuntu yari wajingo ni bashake ngo break even ahita yumva break even agashaka kujya muri bya finance gusa akumva ko bakalculatinga break even mu buryo bwa finance y'umuhaye zirya data zo muri finance zisanzwe ashobora kukwereka break even ariko when it comes to mathematics for example kujya kubishyira mu mibare isanzwe muri function z'undi ugasanga ntibabishumba ntibumva what they should nyamara kandi uri the other side utibwira ngo ntibaba bizwa musubiritsi ubabwiye ibyo biri byo batakabaye babikora baba babishobora hari no babishobora ariko ugasanga ntabwo yumva niyo language harimo na gap between that language between mathematics these functions and the interpretation is terms of business. So ubwo niba nashaka kugira ngo ndo mbafasheho bajye n'igihe umuntu ahitwe ikibazo bajye babasha kumva icyo barimo kubazwa icyo ari cyo bagerageze kunirwanaho ntabwo bibari ari akantu kamwe nk'uko afata law ubuye ngitegeko rivuga gutya rizahora rivuga ati nirihinduka kiri kabari kuyo ariko mu mibereho wanu kandi change in many many various ways. So niyo mpamvu bakomeje kuhitamo gukomeza ku interactinga where possible gukonda naboneka kugeza mu kwezi kwa mbere then nkabafashaje nta kibazo mfite koko byose bibari magirirana.
Ndabona tumaze kubona babiri
ba
babiri
babiri. How many were you expecting?
Yes.
We're expecting a Gavish. When you're about to watch a corner, we have a seven hour moon. You have a discussing Yapo, no sons, when nobody knows the go, Jacoba, Jesus, Mova, Yamon, Nanya, Maja, Momagi, and Kakomis and Kavasha.
Reka twihe indi minota cumi turebe ko tubona abandi nibabura dukorane n'aba ngabo
nakora nabo kubera ko ari ibintu nifuza kuzakomeza kubafasha abo baba batangiza bazaboneka mwe muramutse mumbone mwe cyangwa bakareba ukuntu bajya bakuriye twajya dukuretinga link twajya duhurira mfite umwanya nkababwira variabilities zanjye najya nkomeza kubafasha for free nta kibazo. So reka twi minota icumi reba what you can do.
Celeste. Dukorana n'aba babiri. Abandi ntibazi ubwo badutangira hagati cyangwa se dukorana nabo. Katiri recorded. Abandi bazaza nyuma bazajya bayisanga kuri YouTube.
Yeah.
So I think ubona nakuririzinga icyo nshaka kubwira abariho ni uko specifically turimo gushaka uburyo bwo gutanga exam tips ntabwo turimo kwigisha ndashaka kugira ngo abanze babyumve we are not teaching we are just giving exam tips to make sure that you are ready for the exam because teaching would take much time and we don't have that time plus it requires a lot of resources that at the moment we don't have as a result of COVID. But we thought due to the fact that most of the students are not receiving tuition, we needed to do something. Mm-hmm. And one of the measures that we took is to have revision sessions.
Yeah.
Where students meet the tutors, and the tutors are able to pass on the tips, the approaches of how they can approach the professional exam.
Sure.
So, Justin, you're welcome. You can always use the chat box, question and answers. And plus, if you have a burning question that you feel you want to raise using your voice, you can always click on raise hand and it give you a platform to speak to the facilitator. And the facilitator will be able to answer your questions at any time too. So, Celestine, you're welcome.
Thank you. So, hello, guys. Hello.
Yes.
Is he Frank?
Yes, Justin.
I only see Frank.
It's me and the rest, they are there on the attendees. There are two.
But they are following.
Yeah, they are following. Let them send to us through chat box. They are following.
Because I do not see their names, they are not. I do not see their names.
Aleluya, and Samuel, can you talk to us?
Okay, I see now. Aleluya, why? Others, I do not see. Anyway, though. They do not want to show their names. It does not mean that we cannot continue, but it will be better when I hear with their voice, reading me as I have done, so that now we start when we know each other. Hello? Hello, participants. Hello? Yes.
Yes, okay. Can you please click on the green button in front of your name? And I tell you what to do. When you go to panelists, yes, click there. And then in front of the facilitator name, the green button that is there.
Yes.
Right click. Click on more.
Green and what?
Click in front of my name, Frank.
The microphone?
Here on, yes. Click on more.
Then I mute you.
Click on more. Oh, no, more.
Mm-hmm. Then I go to chat. Yes,
make host.
Make host, eh?
Yes. Yes.
Then?
Aleluya and Samuel, you can talk to us now.
Yes, hallelujah. How are you?
I'm fine.
Oh, sorry for this delay. You were also not many. I see you are only.
Aí então. Então. Hello.
Hello. How are you?
We are hearing you.
Yes, I'm Samuel.
You are Samuel. Huh?
Happy to meet you.
Yes. And nice to meet you too.
Yeah, we are sorry for the delay. It wasn't our intention. We are just waiting for others to join, but it seems we cannot keep on waiting for them. They're going to start and then they will find us on our way. Hope you enjoy the session. If you have any questions, always raise your hand. And they will answer your question.
Yeah.
So we can now start, huh?
Yes.
Though you are too, but you can start. So I'm Celestine now, and I'm one who is going to facilitate you and some tips to solve some problems of quantitative. And the way I want to approach this one, and I know that maybe some of you are having some difficulties in mathematics and how to link now mathematics to business. I just want you to give short theory, very short theory, because it's not lecturing now. As I have told you, we are not lecturing, we are just giving you tips. It is just like a summary. And for you, it's better when you continue reading, when you continue doing exercises, so that in case you face any difficulty, then you can create a link where we can continue assisting you, but privately. Are we together? Hello? You guys, hello? Hello? Hello?
Yes, they are hearing you.
Yeah, they do not react. So let's start now from the financial mathematics, if they are hearing, but.
And please remember they are muted. We don't want them to be unmuted because we don't want a different sound from different backgrounds. They can always raise their hand whenever they have a question.
Okay, now, apart from these subtopics, from this topic of financial mathematics, where I showed you that you need to read on simple interest rates, compound interest rates, depreciation, discounting, present and future values, annuities and mortgages, amortization and seeking funds that you are familiar with, as I said, we need to look at now the functions and the applications in the business. It does not mean that we normally do not want to approach that one, just because this one may be, you were familiar with them from secondary, from bachelors, at least compared to these functions that you find most of you are suffering from. So here, I just wanted to start from this one, but as we are progressing, we shall also discuss those subtopics that I did not want to include here now. So starting from the functions, if we are following, we started from quadratic function. According to the syllabus, they started from quadratic function, but it does not mean that you do not want to go and read linear functions, because they are also applicable in a business. But according to the syllabuses, I found that they wanted to talk about this quadratic. I just wanted you to start from there, and we discuss about the quadratic and how we can apply it in business, to solve business problems, business issues. So the quadratic function, by definition, as I said earlier, I'm not lecturing, we're just giving a very short theory. The quadratic function, if you are sharing the screen, you are looking at the screen, that one is given by AX squared plus BX plus C. A, B, C, they are all constants, and A is different from zero. Because if A is zero, this term vanishes. It becomes zero, and then you will be having the function BX plus C, which is now linear function. linear function is bx plus c. But once you add a, which is different from zero, ax squared, now this one becomes quadratic function. That's why here I told you that the quadratic function is this one. Find in the variables the highest power is 2. Now, this function, like any other functions, most especially for quadratic and some any other functions except linear function, because for linear function, you do not talk of maximum or minimum there. We are bringing this element of maximum and minimum because in your business, you need to deal with maximum profits, you need to deal with minimum cost in terms of cost minimization. Are we together? Therefore, when we have this function, quadratic function, how do we find now the minimum points of the function? How do we find the maximum points of the function? Now let's go to the maximum points of the function. If this a, look, you are looking here, is positive number, if a is a positive number, then like this one, for example, you find now the function is opening upward, is when you find that the function is looking like this, opening upward like this. If a is negative, the function opens down upward like this. If a is negative, it opens downward. If a is positive, it opens upward like this. Now, if now it opens downward like this exercise that I took from this past paper of 2017 November, question 1D, you see that A here is negative 4, C is negative 70, then this B is 41.5. Now, how do we find now the maximum or the minimum for this function? Here I did not include that formula because I was not lecturing, but generally for the minimum or the maximum of the function, we look at the point which is the maximum from this function. For maximum, we need to look at the point which is the minimum for this function. Now, according to the given question here, they gave you the profit function now. It is a profit function, but it's given in the form of a quadratic function. And what were you required to do is to find the time which the project will break even. Now here they are bringing this element of breaking even, and you are familiar with the business where you know when you are given some financial data, you can calculate the break-even point, and you all know that the break-even point for the business is when the business does not make a profit, does not make loss. To mean that it does not make profit, does not make loss. Well, how now do we deal with this one? In mathematics, in the functions, here we needed to find the value that makes the function zero. Because even if it is a profit function, if the profit function gives us a zero value, we are not making loss, we are not making profit. Nay, now we are at break-even point. Are we together? So to mean that the tip here is find the zero or the roots for the function and we interpret them as a break-even point to the given function, if we are together. To mean that the one who is following me now is understanding that if I'm given a quadratic function or any function and I'm asked to find the value of the variable like x, like time, like whatever, that the project will break even point, you need to understand that you are required to find the values of which are making the function, a given function, zero. So to solve this one, I believe all of you from secondary, you were taught how to solve quadratic function like this one, where you used to find x1 and x2. You remember, when we are solving it for quadratic equations, to mean that you make, you equate this one to zero and you solve this quadratic equation. Here I'm not teaching how to solve quadratic equation. I believe you remember using the formulas, using factorization, using any method, because there are very various methods to solve a quadratic function. But here what I want to tell you is, since you are asked to find the break-even points for this project, you equate this quadratic function to zero, then you solve for x1, for x2. Is what now we are going to do soon. I want you to have some sheet of papers. You are the one to do that exercise. Then we share the findings we have found. Now, two, they are asking us the initial cost of the project. You businessman, you businesswoman, you know, for the initial cost of the project, here you are asked to find what? In a business, before you run any operation, business operation or business operations, you are at initial stage of the business. This is pure mathematics. If you talk of the initial cost of the project, here you understand what is the value of the cost the project is incurring before it starts operations, project operations. How do I solve this one now? The initial cost of the project. Now, if you want to find the initial value of the function, because it's what we do in mathematics, to find the initial value of the function, I have f of x here, which is equal to 41.5x minus 70 minus 4x squared as a function. Then I need to find what is the value of this f of x if x is zero. To mean that I'm going to make this x zero, this one zero, then I compute the value of the function. You guys, it is very clear that if this term is zero, if this one is zero, the whole of these two terms, they vanish, they become zero. So to mean that the value of f of x here will be minus 70. Now, you remember, you businessman, you businesswoman, if you find the value of the profit function and you find it is minus 70 already, I know you all interpret it as a loss. Are we together? Here we do not interpret it as a loss because you cannot make loss at initial stage. We make loss after some project operations. Therefore, even if this variable x will be negative 70, we interpret it as positive cost. To mean that this positive, make it positive number, which is going to be our initial cost at this Roman two, your businessman, your businesswoman, you know, if it is now at initial stage, it simply means that this is what you used to call the fixed cost. The fixed cost means the cost you are incurring, either you are in operations or you are not, but it is, you are still, the project is still incurring the fixed cost. If you have understood all of these tips now, we can now go to the next slide here. And if you do not understand, please you raise the hand so that we continue in this way. Because this is the number that I want you to approach. So solve this one. Get a short of papers on your own. Try to solve this one now using the same tips I told you. Then we share the results. I give you, let me have what is now 6.37 in 7 minutes. I make sure we come up with the results that we are going to discuss all of us. Seven minutes, we all start. We all share the results we have found in 7 minutes, then we go to the next one. Guys, it's almost time. What have you found for Roman 1? Hello? 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 Hello, guys. Hello? Hello? Guys, are we together? Are we together? Our Maron. Frank. Hello? Hello? None of them is with me. Connection problems? Hello? Hello? Do I slide if you want not to? Hello? Hello. Anyway, I don't know what's wrong, but it does not mean that we do not continue. Maybe as I'm still waiting for your feedback, because it's almost the time I gave you, five minutes, and it's almost over. So let's continue now. So I just wanted you, all of us, to be here to share the results you have found, so that maybe I make sure that we do not have those problems, and we see how we can overcome them, but I do not hear any of you. So let's go to the next. We give now the functions. As I'm looking for your feedback, because now I do not see if we are together or if you are not. So for other functions now, where the highest power or the highest degree, the variable is more than two, are not approached in the same way as that one of quadratic, because they are, of course, different functions. Like this one that we are given from this paper, the theory behind for the same as the previous explanations, we are all about maximization, minimization, but in this case, we normally use derivatives to find the maximum and the minimum. We can also go for break-even or the initial value of the function if they exist, and we try them in the given context. Given constant, you want to mean if it is about profit maximization, if it's about the cost minimization, or if I want to deal with the initial values, for example, the initial capital, like the initial goods, like initial whatever, depending upon the context the problem is given in. So the theory behind it for such functions and any other function other than this one, I can give you even 2^4, 2^4, whatever. The hint is, or the tip is, find the first derivative and equate it to zero. The first derivative, you equate it to zero, and you solve for the variable here. You solve for the variable, and solve. These are the main tips you should remember. The first derivative, because sometimes when you are trying to mark, we normally do not look at the final answer. We need to know, does the candidate know that he or she was supposed to find the first derivative of the function for Roman one, for this one, for example, or this one? Because they are all, you have to go through the first derivative. If, for example, the candidate is required to find the maximum or the minimum, does he or she know that is going to equate the first derivative to zero is another step. Now, after equating it to zero, do you know that you are going to solve for the variable? Or in other words, to find what we call the critical values. Now, if you are interested in the maximum or the minimum, you go to the second derivative here, then you test the other break-even points. The break-even points here, you want to mean these values you have found there, which are making your function, the first derivative, zero. Now, for you to decide whether it's maximum or the minimum, now you need to test the following. If the second derivative is negative, then the other value you found there is maximum. And the second derivative here is positive, then the other value found there will be minimum. Unfortunately, I don't know if we are together, so that now we apply the same information. Now, if we go to the interpretation of these functions, derivative functions, as one can bring even the interpretations, because I know sometimes when we are starting such kind of things, we normally do not focus on the applications in the business sometimes. But here, it is now the case. We are going to apply the same idea, but in a business. Now, look at the function that you were given from this paper of 2017, December, question 6A. They gave you this function. They called it revenue function. All of this one defines the revenue function. They give you the revenue function, and they ask you, one, to find the marginal revenue function. They ask you to find the maximum revenue. Given the revenue function here, find the marginal revenue function. Now, back to the function, the derivative function. All the times, once we are trying to find the first derivative of the function, we are talking of the marginal. Marginal means what? If I'm talking of revenues, as it is the case here, I want to mean what is the revenues correct from additional quantity I'm producing. One additional unit I produce, does it generate how much? It is the revenue collected from one extra unit produced, is what you are asking here. Is that one going to be guided by what? You first, just first, define the first derivative, and then you get what you are required here to find marginal revenue function. Marginal revenue function means the result you are going to find from this derivative is going to be in the form of a function. That's why they are not asking you what is the value of the value of the revenue from one extra unit produced. Because once you find the first derivative of this function, you do not get the value. You again get the function. Here to me, that's what I claim even earlier, that we need to continue discussing these things so that you come up with a deep understanding that can enable you to approach any number, even if it is changed anyway. You need to remember now how do we find the derivatives. Because here now, I'm not now teaching the derivatives as they told you. We're not here to teach you, but me, I shall try, as I know, maybe some of you do not have good background in this area. That's why now I remind you, for example, go and revise the derivative, because here is what you were asked to find. But the tip here is given there, and the criteria you should base on to decide. Now, once you find the first derivative of this function here, you get what you call the marginal revenue function that I'm coming to define, to interpret in the area of the business. Now, go to the Roman two. Here we are asked to find the maximum revenue. We are given here the revenue function, but we don't know what should be the maximum revenue. To find the maximum revenue, we use the same function here, but we go through the tips I gave you there. The first derivative is found already in Roman one. You equate it to zero. Equating it to zero, you are now starting Roman two. Then you solve for that function. You get the values of x, maybe x1. Since we have, again, the theorem in our algebra telling us that once you have such kind of function with the highest power is the 3, here we are supposed to get 3 variables. We are supposed to get x1, x2, and x3. From x1, x2, x3, you are going to find, you need to test them, the ones you are getting from here, once we equate the first derivative here to zero, and you solve for Q1, Q2, Q3 are the values we are going to find. And these values we are finding here are the ones we call the critical values. Critical values because we don't know if they are maximum or minimum, but either maximum or minimum is coming from only those three, the possible three values you are getting from Q1, Q2, Q3 from there are the ones we are going to find which ones are maximum or minimum. But in our case, that's just the maximum. So we need to test what? We need to test the maximum value of this function. How do I go through this one? Tips are given. First derivative is found in Roman one, equate it to zero, solve for the critical values. After coming to the critical values, find the second derivative. The second derivative means if you find the first derivative from here, then is the same function in Roman one, where we're going to find its derivative again, which is going to be our second derivative for that function. The Therefore, after getting the first, the second derivative in Roman 2, then test the other points you found there. The other values you found there, 1, 2, 2, 3. In the first derivative, put now for Q1, the second derivative, what is the value of the revenue? If it's positive, you remember that value is minimum. If you go to Q2 and you substitute it in the second derivative you found there, and you find the value of the revenue now is negative, that value is maximum. You continue the process, you test for all the three, you test for all the three values of Q1, Q2, Q3. Again, as we are concluding. Once you get a Q1, Q2, Q3, because the highest power of Q is 3, for example, and maybe Q2 is minimum, because maybe it gives you negative. And here, you are having two values which are showing you that they are all maximum. Then you pick which one, because you cannot have two maximums which are equal. You get two maximum, for example, 2 and 7 is an example, because not yet solved. But since 2 is maximum of this function, 7 is the maximum for this function, then 7 is the highest one and you need to answer in drawing the decision or conclusion for this one. Guys, I don't know if you are following me, because I just wanted you to participate in this session, but this is the way I wanted you to go through this one. Are we together or we are not? Hello? I don't know if I continue in this way if you are not there. If I do not see the feedback from you. Hello, guys. Hello? Hello, guys. I do not see the feedback. So let me give you again. Let me give you again 5 minutes. So I do not see the feedback from you. And I see how you found the results, and we try to discuss them before we go to the next slide.
Hello, Celeste.
Yes.
Abanyeshuri barahari igisha.
Bara?
Yeah, they are listening to you.
They are not coming.
No, students are there, you teach.
They continue just talking, they do not give the feedback.
Ah, yeah, you'll get the feedback at the end.
I get their feedback at the end.
Yeah, that is better. Otherwise, if I unmute them, I go move the kumbi kanaza kuzamu rushakuru kuyishuru vamu background tano kani.
Anyway,
rero nukwigisha uze kugena uwo muje gusoza gena nisa cyangwa iminota 30. Aho turuze kuba umwanya bakaje babaza ikibazo babaza iki usubiza ibibazo byabo ndetse muri make.
Okay.
Ariko ubu ngubu tugize urumva umuntu yafunguye yamenyutinze haza mu rusaku n'undundi akaza mu rusaku n'undundi akaza mu rusaku ugasanga nanone ntabwo urimo kwigisha urarwana n'urusaku ruva mu different background.
As long as they are following.
Barahari no muri comments barimo baragukurikira rwose baraho.
Let me now continue, then they shall give me the feedback.
I know. Ni barekuye bose buri mwe akaza mu rusaku rwa buri munyeshuri kuko nago barahantu twese tuzi fagutanga umuntu ari hantu mu rugo arema abandi banavugiramo utuma nabandi batumva neza.
Okay, let me continue, then I give them like 30 minutes.
Please bear with us. Nago kuba yuko akwigize ariko no kugira ngo tutaza kubangamirana hagati yacu twese.
Okay, let me continue.
So it's better for us to get a minute on you. If you have a job, you can move your chat box, Tango Janikahano, Mistuza Kujera, Miss Jerana Sandi, Father Fungura, Mazi was of Janu, and the freeze. I come Mukrik and there, if there was here a Mujuza, and we was a mother to develop in the Muzakuva than you.
Okay, let it now.
Is it? Okay, I'm clear.
Now, if things are clear now, let's do it that way. Now, for this one, I'm coming to close chapter number one. Then we go to this one. For the next topic, which was about source of data presentation and their use, it does not mean that you don't go and read the theories behind. It's also that where we normally get statistical data. Here I'm interested in the presentation and the use. I picked some past papers there, the past paper for 2019 June, was 22B, and the past paper of 2016 November, was 21D, and I tried to give now the tips to solve. Representing the data ni compound budget. It does not mean that we normally present the data in this format alone. No, we have various ways of presenting the data, like this one, budget, for example, like OGI, for example, like frequency polygons, for example, like there are various methods that we cannot go through all of them, but I know you are familiar with some from even secondly, I know. So the tip now to approach such numbers, I found that most of the candidates, they lose some marks just because they do not make what the markers should follow. They normally do not mark the final answer. They just mark step by step. Here, I advise you guys, once you are going to present such information, not only for this chapter, even for any other chapters that require the candidate to present the information or the data, you first need to draw what we call the Cartesian plane. with wood scales on both X and Y axis. Why this one? Because maybe the one who set the number just wanted to know to test whether the candidates know this Cartesian plane, how they draw it, how they scale it, and then you find they put some marks. But in some cases, I'm telling you guys, you find your candidates are just drawing the Cartesian plane as they want. They do not even labor the axis, those axes, they do not show what is the X, what is the Y. You find it, they even do not put the arrow heads, they just draw it just like that. And you find that they are losing marks, yet there are some marks maybe allocated to such step. Then you need to go and read the data you have. You plot the points correctly and you draw the required frequencies as you are asked to do. For this one, I did not give you much, though I know maybe I should share you with some exercise with the various types of presenting the data, the statistical data, but generally presenting the data, you need to, most especially when it is about presenting the information, most especially in the frequencies, the ogive, whatever, frequency polygons and so forth, you need to draw the Cartesian plane properly. You label it X and Y, you put the arrow heads, you put the origin zero, where they meet, the two axes meet, and then at least you get that max, then you wait for the max for plotting, where you read on scales, either on X and Y, and then you mark points, then you draw those frequencies we are talking about. Here I did not put, I just gave you some of these past papers so that you can go and read those exercises and they tell me which one now I'm not able to present. So let me go to the next now topic. Then I receive the questions after, which is about networking analysis. For the networking analysis, I gave you. Yes?
Can you please use our Kanuko Kuri Noza Kujangwa? They are not viewing it well.
They are not viewing what?
Screen ya wena gijara garaneza.
Screen ya jana gijara garaneza?
Koresha yu ya kara kanu kara o hasi.
Which one, for example? Don't they see my screen properly? Don't they see my screen?
Reba kanu hasi. Kanu handi te anarutu twasi turiho na zoom.
On this one?
Kuri presentation muri PowerPoint. Manuka hasi. Aha, oi, hirya. Hirya wola. Not. Komeza hirya mu buryo bwawe.
This one?
Komeza.
This one is clear. Okay.
Yeah, hang up.
Okay, fine. If now this one is clear, it's okay.
That one is very clear.
If this one is very clear, now it's okay. Now for the networking analysis, you guys who are following, why do we need now this one? We normally need this one for scheduling the projects implementation when you need to come up with and the resources are required for the projects. How do we deal with this one? I give you just a short theory behind this topic, then we go into application of it. One, in the project, you know, projects have many various activities. And it is, no, let me start even if not from activities, let me start from tasks. There are various tasks in the project. And then from these tasks, we group similar tasks into what we call activities. Similar tasks, we group them into activities. We come up with the activities. Having these activities, I need to know how these activities are sequencing now. Which activity starts or can start simultaneously, or which activity can start before other activities have completed. Something like that. We need to network like that. That's why I call it networking analysis. But here, my dear friends, not only drawing this network, we need also to analyze the critical activities, non-critical activities, critical path. Though part of crushing the activity was not part of this chapter for your program, we also need to know if I want to shorten the time duration of the project, which activities do I deal with? This one is very much helpful because even if you want to allocate resources to those particular activities, you know, you now need to identify the types of resources you are going to allocate for each activity, the amount of the resources that you need to allocate for each activity, and all of that, those are resources that at the end of the day are the ones guiding us to calculate the budget for the whole project. Now, these are now the tips I advise you in the drawing, networking. Then, after having these tips, I shall share maybe if you do not have these tips, not necessarily that the one who is going to mark is going to follow tip one, tip one, two. This is just a theory helping you to draw the network, but they look at the activities you have drawn properly. You have networked properly. So what now we should do? Giving the such question to approach, I need to look at the precedence of activities. How activities precede others. To avoid looping error. Looping errors here, what do you want to mean? Loop, you know what loop is. Suppose you are doing this activity, you draw this activity like this, you draw this activity like this, then you loop like that. This is an error. We need to apply now that one as follows. Precedence activities. What activity must be completed immediately before this activity starts? You are looking at activity A. You ask yourself, what activity or activities must be completed immediately before this activity starts? You try to identify those activities. The next question, what activity should follow this? Which activity should follow this one? If activity, if you start from activity A, I need to know, to ask myself, what activity or activities that need to be completed immediately before that activity A starts? I highlight those activities, identify them. Then I need to ask myself again, what activity are following activity A? Third, what activity or activities must occur simultaneously with this activity? Which activity should go simultaneously with that activity A you have identified, you started with? That is the first tip guiding you to draw network without errors. Because in drawing networks, we found that maybe many, many are trying to commit such errors and they lose marks for nothing. Then we go to the logical sequence. An event cannot occur until all the incoming activities into it have been completed. Here, what do I want to mean as an event? If you are looking at my cursor here on this screen, suppose I'm drawing this activity here. I'm drawing this activity here, and I'm drawing this activity, this one, and this one they meet here. Here is where I shall read events. Here I shall read them, the events. If you know, if you continue reading, you shall find that these events are where normally we measure the milestones of the project. To mean that a set of activities to accomplish this particular event. They have this activity, and they all come up with the same event. Then we go to the next for the logical sequence, that activity cannot start unless all the precedence activities on which it depends have been completed. The next, though dummy activities means these activities which are not consuming resources. They are just introduced for the purpose of growing the network. They don't consume either.
Okay.
So it is still has the following rules. Rule 4.1, Rule 4.2, and identification of the critical and non-critical activities. So keep to identify now those ones. For forward computation that we are going to see soon, we pick the maximum since they meet at the event that I'm coming to explain. We pick the minimum if I'm going for the forward computation. So here it is maximum. Forward computation, I have to pick, pick the maximum, and I pick the minimum for backward computation. Means that if they start, every project has its start and its end, if I start from here, I'm going this way, this is the forward computation. Then I shall pick maximum if they meet at an event, certain event. And if I start from the end of the project, I shall pick the minimum if the activities they meet at the event, I shall pick the minimum. So that now, at the end of the day, for the events, I find that either earliest start we are going to define and the latest start times are equal, those activities you shall define are the ones we call the critical activities. Others are not critical, are not critical activities, and a set of critical activities are the ones which I define as the critical path according to your program. So the next, I can give you this one as illustration for those ones maybe who are not familiar with this one, to explain the way you compute this data in drawing the network, so that maybe we come up with the earliest start time and the latest start time in a network. This is the start, this is the end of our project, as I was explaining. Now, this activity A have 7 maybe days or weeks, or yeah, they did not mention the units, but maybe a few, maybe like days. Now, this is having 7, this is having 17, this is having 12 days. Now, from here to there, if they meet here, you see now I'm computing forward computation. This is 7, this is 15. This is 17. Once they meet here, I must pick the maximum. I have to pick the maximum that I put there, here. I continue the same way. This number of days, getting to here, you know, this is another option. Then to come like this, and like that. Getting there, adding these days, these times, these activities, of these activities, I pick the maximum. Getting here, do the same. I know for me, from here to get there, there are various also paths. I can go like this way, go like this way. I can go like this way, like this way, like this way, like this way. Like this way, like this way, like this way, and like that way. Then getting there, I always pick the maximum. Now, starting from here, using the same information there, I pick now the minimum. From here to there, I can get to there, direct straightforward like this way, or I can go like this, I get to there. Getting to there, I shall pick now the minimum, because I'm going backward computation. I continue the whole process until I get there. To get there, I have to get the same data that I had when I was here. Therefore, I look at now what is the earliest start time, what is the latest finish time or start time. All the information is already available in your network, and then you can continue this process. You come up with now the critical activities. As I said earlier here, that the critical activities are the ones you find these earliest start and the latest start times are equal, are the same. These activities are the ones which identify from this network here diagram, and we qualify them as critical activities. The set of those critical activities are the ones we qualify as the critical path. Now, here is an example. This example was taken from this paper of 2019 June, question 5C. They are telling us the following table shows precedence activities, as we defined earlier, in the first simple project of preparing tea and break time at this maybe business. Activities here are given A up to H. These are their description. Activity A is about doing this one. Activity B is about doing this one, and so forth. These are the preceding activities. Activity A does not need any activity to start or to finish so that you can start. Anytime you can start activity A. This is what it means. Then B, for activity B to start, it is when A has completed. Activity C does not need any activity to complete. It can start anytime. To mean that the other question I used to tell you, what I am looking, they above, here, yes. This one and this one. Here I'm showing the other tips I gave you. These ones, this activity, A, the activity A and activity C can start simultaneously. Activity B to start, it waits A to complete. Activity D waits D to complete. Activity E waits B, D to complete. Activity F waits E to complete. Activity this one waits C to complete. To mean that this activity and this one, for them to start, they wait the same activity C and to complete. To complete. Then this activity H waits this activity and this one to complete. Now, look, going back to the tips I gave you there that you are trying to follow while you are doing exercises, then you come up with the network. Here are the allocation time, duration in seconds. You take this number of seconds and so on like that. What we require to do is to draw an activity network for the above project to identify the earliest start time for each activity and determine the critical path and the duration of the project. To mean that the duration of the project, I just added the times of the critical activities. To mean this one is the longest. We call it the longest path. My dear friends, drawing this network, you need to avoid the other errors. Because we are not normally teaching, as they told you, I did not put all the errors that we are making while drawing networking. There is the ones we call dangling error. Hey guys, once you are drawing now the dummy, this dummy activity, I told you that we draw the dummy activity or activities for the purpose of drawing network. Because for this dummy, we do not allocate time, we do not allocate any resource. It does not consume any time, does not consume any resource. We just draw them for the purpose of networking. My dear friends, once we introduce, sometimes you find candidates drawing, for example, this activity like this one, following the sequences as it is here, as it is seen here. And you find like this, like this, like this, and you find, I do not see now the next, let me put just the dummy like this one. You introduce an unnecessary dummy. This is an error. You needed to introduce the dummy in the case it is to be introduced. Once you are introducing many dummies, unnecessary dummies, you are making errors in drawing your network. So therefore, we need to know where to introduce the dummy, where not to introduce dummy. So for this one, I just wanted you to do this one, though we found that maybe we get the time to receive your queries. I just want you to participate because teaching this one or assisting you in this module, it's when you all participate, you try to work, you give the feedback after very limited time, we discuss about the findings so that you go with something with such that anybody who can change the number in any way, you can go and try it for yourself. Though I do not see now the feedback as I was preparing this one as my methodology to assist you in that way, and it is not possible, but maybe for the next times, we should see the way you can improve such that I see the feedback and I make sure that maybe what I'm doing is very much helpful for you to do exercises of the same type from these chapters. So this is the way I just want you to solve this one, and then let me go to this one as I just want you to give you some time for feedback and ask questions, and we see the way you can maybe improve or do what is suitable for you. So let me go to this chapter. Though I'm keeping you a short theory on the way we should do these things and tips we should go through so that you do not lose all the marks, you do not jump all the steps as some students used to do. And even if you do not get the final answer, but at least you get some marks from the steps you tried to do. I just wanted you to do exercise though. I do not see your feedback now. So let me go to the linear programming. Here I'm giving you short theory and tips we should go through when approaching any number from these chapters, because generally we can change these numbers in any way as it is quantitative. You can change them, you can, but if you understand the theory behind, short theory behind, and these tips, I'm telling the truth, you can do some steps, even in many steps, even if you do not get the final answer, but at least you try to do some steps from these numbers that we have discussed. Now, once it comes to, if you understood now most each and everything from this networking, let's also discuss this one. And for this networking, you shall do this one for me and some of any others. If you face any challenge, please, you raise the query so that we can assist you. So let me go to this one, then I give you time to ask some questions or to give some comments, and maybe we shall organize another session for some other topics, most especially for probability, most especially for sampling and sampling distributions, most especially for various probability distributions and other topics. All the topics I want to approach them in this way, or maybe you advise the way to improve while you are doing some exercise. I just wanted you, all of us, to do this exercise. Once I finish the topic, I give now, I pick any number from past papers. We discuss it, all of us, when you are working to, I'm working to, then at the end of the day, I share you these slides when I put the solved exercise as it was supposed to be solved. But when I make sure that everybody is participating, because doing quantitative requires everybody to participate. It's not like any other maybe modules where it requires you just to go and read. This one requires you to work so that when you face difficulties, we know where you are stuck and we help you, because it involves various prerequisites, most especially like the other ones I told you, requiring derivatives and the higher, we are not having curriculums that we are supposed to do. But if you find that you are stuck from there, we help you. If we start now probability, we shall see that we need, for example, some theories in the set theory that is not appearing on the program, but you need to go and read that one. I can share you a reading material in terms of those prerequisites so that maybe you can understand now those topics. So let's go to the linear programming. Then after this one, maybe I give you time for feedback and I see the way or the areas to improve. So once you are given now the linear, where now do we apply the linear programming? We normally apply the linear programming in the problems of optimization. Optimization means, does not mean, many countries think that optimization means maximization. No, even minimization, we are optimizing. Because for example, we are minimizing the cost of production. We are optimizing. If you are maximizing, for example, the revenues, there you are optimizing. So the term is used for both, either minimizing or maximizing. Now, how do we go through this one? If you have some pains because I did not put it in everything as it was not teaching, just maybe helping you to have some short theory on this one, then we do, and the tips, then we do some exercises, even if you do not finish it, and we look at the interpretation of the findings, in the business or in the context of the question. But I believe if you follow this one, maybe the short theorem I'm providing shall help you. Now, I was coming to say that linear programming is mostly used in problems optimization, maximization, minimization. It's up to you to read the given problem. You know whether you are maximizing or you are minimizing. But to me, to the linear programming topic, you are in optimization, if you are following me. Now, read the problem carefully. Come up with the information whether you are maximizing or minimizing. Then, after reading the problem, you try to identify what you call the decision of variables in the problem. Decision of variables in the problem are the ones we are asked to optimize. We are the ones that we are asked to optimize the, what you call the objective function. Which is the objective? The objective is to maximize. Which is the objective? The objective is to minimize. Therefore, identify the decision of variables in the problem that we are going to use either to maximize or minimize. Two, identify the constraints in the problem. Are you constrained in what? In resources. When we are in production, you are constrained in resources because they are scarce. And you know, once you are producing and you are not optimizing this one, then how I want you to compete to the market when you are producing at a high cost, for example. Then, as I said, for three, form the objective function. Then form the inequalities of the constraints. Form the non-negativity constraints because we are not producing negative numbers of items. And then you use any method to solve either graphical method or simplex method, depending upon the method you are asked to use. Most of the students, they suffer from simplex method. For graphical method, when we are having like two variables, decisional variables, it's very easy for those ones who know how to graph the linear functions that I said earlier. But when it comes to three decisional variables, four decisional variables, you cannot now graph. Because the graph, we are graphing lines, straight lines. What if now your objective function, for example, is having three variables, four decisional variables? Are you going to draw a line in four dimensions? For two decisional variables, it's simple because you draw X and Y, where I define the values of X, the values of Y. But what if now I come with three decisional variables or four? For the three decisional variables, if you want to plot them, then you need you no longer need the Cartesian plane. We do not use that one because now you should have X, Y, and Z. The Z here will be an amplitude. So now you are in space. You are no longer in the plane. You are now in space where you have X, you have Y, and then the amplitude or the altitude. Then you are not studying this topic in that way. That is the limitation of it. That's why now we go to the simplex method. And the simplex method is good because you can use it to solve three to four and so on decisional variables, as can be used to solve for two decisional variables the way graphical method works. So to mean that simplex method work in all the cases, but graphical method, it works just when we are having only two decisional variables that you shall plot on X and Y. So these are the tips. Now, you get your pen again for those ones who are interested in this one. How now do I try to write, for example, the objective function? How do I write these constraints now? For the non-negativity, it's very simple. Where I should say X and Y are supposed to be positive, all of them, greater or equal to zero. This is simple. But what about now these inequalities? What about now the objective function? My dear friends, if you go through these steps and we found the marker may be found that you try to identify the decision variables, you get your marks. If you try to identify the constraints now in your problem, you are trying to get marks. If you write the objective function, either maximize or minimize, you are getting marks. If now you try to write the other inequalities of the constraints, you are getting marks. And then there are negativity functions from this tip to this one. We are doing what we call building model, linear programming model. Now you will come up with a model. After writing this one, even if you clean the other story, the other problem, since you have the data and you have built the model, then the next phase is to do what? Is to solve the model either graphical or simplest method. Now let me give now like an example. It's an example. If, for example, me, sometimes when you understand the theory behind this one helps you in case you are given a problem, maybe with incomplete information. You already know that. But if you do not have any theory behind this one, you just go and waste your time working on maybe the problem which is having wrong information. Yet you are supposed to raise that one, and maybe the information is provided because you are a human being. One, let me go to these decision variables that we usually name as X, Y, Z, and so on. X stands for the number of items, for example, I'm producing. Y stands for the number of items I'm producing, and so on. Then for me to form the linear programming model, give me for these constraints that we normally call them the resources you are using to do production, for example, which amount of resources do you need? Which amount of resources from this type of resource do you need to produce one unit of X? Which amount of resource, for example, like manpower, how many manpower do you consume to produce, for example, one unit of X? How many, for example, let me say steel, do you need to produce one unit of X? That's the information I need. Second information I need on that, I need to know the available resources for that, for any type of the resource. Because are the ones I'm constrained with. How many are variable there that I'm not supposed to produce, and they go beyond their variability because of their constraints, constrained with them. Therefore, I need to know for X, decision variable X, I need to know the amount of labor to produce one unit of X. I need the amount of capital I need to produce one unit of X. I need amount of resources to produce one unit of X, because a unit can maybe require many resources for production. I finish for that one. I go to the next decision variable Y. I do the same for X. I go to the next decision variable Z, and so on, depending upon the number of the decision variables available in the problem. I do the same. Therefore, to write the constraints here, I need to know, for example, let me say the labor. How many labor to produce one unit of X? I take that number of resources, I multiply it by X. Plus, how many labor required to produce Y? One unit of Y. I multiply it by Y. How many labor required to produce one unit of Z, and so on? I multiply it by Z, and so on. Then this one should be less than or equal to the available labor. I work like that for labor. I go to capital, for example. Which amount of capital to produce one unit of X? I multiply by X. I go to Y. Which amount of capital required to produce one unit of Y? I multiply it. I go to Z, and so on. Once I add them and I know the availability of capital, the total of that one should be less than or equal to the available capital, because you cannot produce beyond the availability of the resources. We do all of them and we finish for the constraints. Go to the objective function. before we conclude for this one, then we go for the application. For the objective function, if it is to maximize, for example, the profits, or maximize the profits, I want you to give me the profit per unit of X. I want to know the profit per unit of Y. I need to know the profit per unit of Z, and so on. Therefore, I shall say that the total profit, which is going to be our objective function, will be equal to the profit per unit of X times the number of units of X I shall produce, plus the profit per unit Z, Y times Y, plus the profit per unit Z times the number of units Z that I need to produce. Here, I do not say that is less than or greater than. I stop there. It's just the objective function. Then, once you solve for the inequalities using either graphical method or simplex method, you come up with number of X to be produced, number of Ys you need to be produced, number of Z and so on to be produced. Therefore, those numbers are the ones I'm going to use in the objective function there. Then X, I have its number, I multiply by the profit per unit. I get the total profit for X. I go to Y, I do the same. I have the number of units of Y to be produced. I have the profit per unit Y, I multiply, I add. Then therefore, I get the total profit that I'm going to find. I'm getting the decision of variables, the number of units I need to produce for X, Y, and Z. Then you can go to any of these two methods, depending upon on which you are asked to solve using either graphical simplex. Then for me, I will need of assisting you on using simplex method, because of graphical method, I believe many of them know. But for this one, I just wanted you to use the simplex method so that you can be familiar with it. We call the simplex method to mean that it's simple. So I found that maybe many of the candidates do not use this one because it is a bit time consuming. And you find they just leave it behind. So guys, here was a number from past paper 2019. So I just wanted this number. Here, the information can be given in a compact form like this one in table. They can give you the whole story, they put those numbers there. By having here, they just put in the problem anyway, and you are the one to sort them out. But sometimes they can give you yes.
Can I read the name?
Yeah, they can now, because this, I just want to stop even from there so that they can receive their feedback. And,
yeah, let me hope that we will maintain silence so that we don't have, I mean, create an environment that is too noisy.
Okay.
I'm going to give the right to talk. Whoever wants to talk will be talking, no problem. You all have the right, you can unmute yourself.
Oh, I'm waiting for them.
While you're somewhere, you can unmute. If you want to talk, if you don't want to talk, you can mute and then you let someone else to talk. But if you want to talk, you can unmute and then you talk, and then after you unmute. I think that is okay with you.
Yeah, we can continue.
Yeah. Thank you.
Hello? Yeah. section. Hello. Hello.
Hello.
Yes.
Yeah, I am new.
Yes, I'm here.
Nashakaga kubaza hano twize kuri profit maximization na mini na profit minimization. Hala hano watubwiye tumaze kubona ama variables twakoze first derivative na second twabonye ama q. Iyo twabonye main q dufite q1 q2 q3 tumenye iri minimum. Niho numvishe neza tuvuge urugero dufite nka 7 na 2 kuko ndi wabisobanuye byacitse nitwabyumva ko byose bihuje sign
urakoze kuba ubajije ikibazo ndakiza navuze ko it was the here I remember it was on this one right this one navuze ngo bavuze ngo iyo function ni ifite power irenze kabiri dufite theorem in algebra itubwira ngo niba dufite the highest degree in the function for example is 3 you can even have 4 or 5 and so on it is also very possible you dufite the highest power which is 3 we need to Q1, Q2, Q3.
Yeah.
If it is a function, if it's Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4. Now, when it comes now to test, as you were asking, yes, there, even if it is Q1, Q1 and Q3, they are maximum. No? Niba mfite Q1 and Q3 zikaba ari ziri maximum wende Q2 ari minimum bigenza hagati ya Q1 and Q3 which one is the highest mean maximum niyo nza thinking maximum kubera yuko ari byo twita though it is not at this level with the convex functions nukuvuga ngo nabo dushobora kugira maximum ebyiri nkuko butakeza bamwe nukuvuga ngo niba zose ari maximum fine ndabibonye ko zose ari maximum ariko hari niba hari mutindi rero niyo 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 gufata
ubwo kuri minimum tuzareba ba west variant kuri minimum
Now, to Zari, of course, eating minimum. And you remember, you wait for the minimum. No, could you imagine? The ingredients. Any? I'm still waiting for your feedback.
You can continue your operations still there. If possible, you can continue, sir.
So you want me to continue, but you did not see the feedback for this. Maybe if you tell me session is very much clear to me that anybody who can give you any number from these topics we have discussed that you can approach, this can be very obvious. And what I said, and I said even earlier before this session, I was saying that this module is comprising of 11 chapters, and I know maybe some of you where they suffer, so that maybe they can do, they can have time to do some exercises, and I in the wish of meeting you like 3 times, including this one, so that maybe from chapter 1, chapter 5, that I'm coming to discuss for you, and in the next session, I discuss maybe like 4 chapters, so that maybe for the chapter of probability, I give it much time, because I found from my past experiences that most of the candidates, they fail probability numbers. So I can now give it time when we are even. I was suggesting that maybe, since I'm coming to discuss 5 chapters, and the next time, I can also discuss like 5 chapters, it's also very much possible. And for the last one, for the 3 hours we should be having any other time, I now just discuss for the probability issues so that I make sure that maybe the one who has attended the latest session can try to manage probability problems.
Yeah, but if possible, in the next session, you can add the decision theory.
For that, I know I shall discuss all of them.
Yeah.
I shall discuss all of them today. In fact, it was the plan that I discussed all of those chapters in 3 hours, and I said, this one cannot work for this module. Mm-hmm. Let me discuss maybe the module into 3 sessions. Yeah. So that maybe get the feedback, and I make sure that the short theory and the tips I'm giving to the candidates can help them to solve various exercises, so that in the case maybe for they are coming for the next session, they can come up with some maybe challenges they faced for those chapters discussed. We'll also discuss them. But generally, what I wanted, I just wanted to see the feedback if my candidates are trying to do these numbers I highlighted from these past papers, which are from these topics I'm coming to discuss, so that I make sure that I'm together with my candidates, and this shall help them in a very good approach in answering any number from this module.
Yeah.
So to mean that now I have discussed the 5, next session, I can discuss also 5, so that I reserve the last session for the probability and the probability distributions, mm-hmm. and how to use them in the business issues, mm-hmm. so that maybe I make sure that the candidates who are motivated, they can also go and solve any probability problem, even if they do not get the right answer, the final answer, but at least they go with the steps and they can get a max from any probability number.
Yeah.
So what I want you is, most especially, is the feedback of the methodology, and what I want you to equip from these chapters we come to discuss, so that maybe you are going and you'll be busy with solving. I shall even see how I can share you the slides we shall discuss, so that maybe, as it is a short theory on how to approach these numbers, maybe you are solving, and when you are stuck, you can go to the theory for that particular chapter, and you see if you can come up with the solution of it. And I shall share you the solution for these numbers I highlighted in those I shall show you even the final solutions up to the final answers, so that maybe once you see the way this one is solved, you can go and solve some others almost similar from the.
But sir, there are still remaining one question, if possible, I can ask.
Yes.
Hello?
Can you ask it, please?
Yes.
There is a question on networking analysis.
The question on
pre-networking analysis.
Yes.
Now to wundi bajya babaza ni kintu cya crashing.
Bajya babaza ikibazo cya crashing.
Yeah, nago igeze duherezaho some tips on crashing.
For sure, I saw that number a bit long ago even. Let me tell you this one. Sometimes, when you are revising the module, I believe you use the program that HPI provided, isn't it?
Yeah.
You check if you find the certain number that is not appearing there. You raise your claim. I was for the crashing. For crashing, we are here, right?
Yes.
We are here. So for crashing, the theory behind the crashing, generally crashing was not appearing on this, but let me get opportunity to explain the crashing and how we do crashing. Generally, when we crash, what crashing is first? Crashing is shortening the time duration of the project. You remember here, I said at this Roman 2 that we need also to determine the total float for each activity. And this one is the same as this number. I'm saying for this one, critical path, which is a set of critical activities. From this one, I define the time duration of the project. After finding the time duration of the project, then, depending upon the client can tell you, no, it was expected that the project is going to complete in, for example, 17 weeks. Please, can't you complete the project in 14 weeks? You see, now the client wants 14 weeks. And you, according to the estimates you have came up with, you found maybe the project, the expected time duration of the project is 17 days. And the client is wants you to complete the project in 14 days. Therefore, it requires you to do what? To shorten the time duration of the project. Once now it requires you to shorten the project, the time duration of the project, what does this mean? It simply means that you are going to request additional resources so that you complete the activities earlier than expected. Once you need additional resources, when you are going to incur the costs for those resources. Therefore, the networking was for the purpose of managing these projects in time, in cost, plus the coverage. Here I want to manage the scope of the project. You need to look at the time, managing time. You need to manage the cost, yeah, meaning the budget. Once you are looking at now the scope of the project, you also don't forget the quality of the deliverables. Therefore, the clients want you to complete the project earlier than expected. And you, as a project manager or the manager, you are now going to request additional resources. Additional resources means if you have planned the budget for that project using your networking analysis, the budget you have planned before is going to increase just because you are going to shorten the time the project was supposed to be completed. Once you completed the earlier than that, then you are going to incur extra budget. So meaning that the client, even if he's claiming for you to complete the project earlier than expected, on your side as a manager, you need also to claim for additional resources, additional budgets. Therefore, when we are dealing with the crashing, is what we are doing. We are trying to manage How can I shorten the time duration of the project to be completed earlier than expected? And what can be additional budget or additional resources? But we need to manage that. Are we together? There is what we call the slope, time slope, is what we use generally, the time slope. Me, I did not bring that one because I did not see it in in this module. Generally, it is not there. Maybe even if I saw it in some past papers, we can get even a time also to discuss these crushing activities. How do we crush activities? But crushing, what we do, we first of all find the time slope. To mean that what you are given here, they give you information about normal time, crushing time. They give you normal cost, and they give you crush cost. They give such information so that you now compute what you call the slope. After computing the slope, the formula for computing the slope is the one we use now in the crushing activities. Now, crushing activities, what does that mean? It simply means that you are going to crush what we call critical activities. We normally crush the critical activities. What is the idea behind crushing the critical activities? The non-critical activities, even if you shorten their time duration, you can find there is nothing you have shortened for the total completion of the project. But once for these critical activities, you shorten them one day, automatically, the whole project is shortened one day. Are we together? If you shorten the critical activity 2 days, if the 2 days are possible, to shorten for that critical activity, the whole project shall be shortened by 2 days. But my friend, the information of is given. Given why? It is given because if you want to work, for example, I cannot build it, for example, in 2 seconds. For crushing activity, there is a minimum time you cannot go below for completion of that activity. That time is given. So, madam, thank you for raising that question. And I see it's almost time. I came to where I can get high network. And I also want to go a bit still early. We can even continue that. But normally, that's the way normally do crushing the activity and the idea behind the crushing those activities. We crush the critical for the allowed time for crushing that is given. They give you time for crushing, normal time, crush time. They give you normal cost and the crush cost. Then we find what we call the slope. Then you go to those critical active. Can you give me, let me can share you? You want me to share you that one?
Yes, of course.
Yes, of course.
Let me see. I have time then to discuss it using this illustration. Let me check if I have this one around and I share you. But if there's any other queries, please raise them while I'm searching for this slide so that maybe we can use the same example for explaining this. Let me, if I can share this one, like this one, like this one, basically. Do you see that, this one now? You guys, do you see this one or you continue?
Yeah.
Yes.
Now have a look at this one now. What I was saying, this is what example, you see the activities as area. This is the sequence of those activities. Now here we give you, this is the time, this is the cost. Now, the normal time for activity A is this one, and the crashing time is this one. This crashing time I was talking about, activity A cannot be crashed indefinitely, if you have followed me. Meaning that, as I was giving an example, you cannot build, for example, this hall or this building in some seconds, for example. So that time is given. Giving me normal time, and you give me allowable crashing time. You give me the cost for this activity A, and you give me the crashing cost for this activity A. Now, the information is given throughout like this one. Now, since I pick, if you are following me well, for the other slope, if I take, for example, the crashing time here, the crashing cost here, minus the normal cost, and I divide it by the normal cost minus the crushing cost, I come up with now the cost for crushing A by 1 day. I get the cost for crushing activity A per 1 day. I do throughout all of those activities. So, for the same, they gave here the indirect cost, which was varying like that. For 15 days, the indirect cost was this one. For 14 days, for 13 days, and so forth. If you complete the project in 15 days, this is the indirect cost you should add, and so on. Then, as area, I asked my candidate to draw the arrow diagram and to determine the project duration, which results in the minimum cost. Then I draw the network, as I told you. The doubling error I told you as an error, when you draw this one like this one, and maybe you do not draw this arrow. This one is left outside the network, and we call it doubling error. Therefore, I just go to this one. This is now the way of computing the crash. Though you wanted me to discuss this one, and I did not see, I did not find this one in your program. But as you are interested to know, they also get time to discuss with me. We still have some minutes if you do not have any other questions. Now, this now is when I started now crashing. Look. For this activity, let me go back here. I do not see where you put the these results. I did not indicate the results. But once you draw the network like this one, here we found that the project duration was normally supposed to be 13 days. Are we together? From this one?
Yes.
By adding up the duration for the critical activities we have identified, we came up with the total duration of the project, a normal duration of the project of 13 days. The normal cost, I went to this one, the normal cost. The normal cost here. The normal cost here. After finding the total cost, the total time of the project, I added the cost of four. Those activities, I came up with a normal cost of the project, which is in this now, which is this one. This is the normal cost of the project if it is completed in 13 weeks. So there was no need of rushing. The total cost is still as the same as this one. And this 400 was from the other table of indirect cost that was given. I gave it to my students. 13 days is this one for 13 weeks, if I can say. This is the indirect cost. So the total cost for the project will be the normal cost plus indirect cost that you are giving me according to the number of days. This is like fixed cost, if I can say. Therefore, I came up with this number. Then taking this one, indirect cost plus the normal cost, I came up with the total cost of the project as this amount. If you allow me to complete my project in 13 days as planned, then you want me to go for crushing. You want me to shorten the project. And I told you that the idea behind, as you want me to reduce the total number of time for the project, for the normal time for this project, then if I complete the project in 12 days, let's look at the cost. The cost is doing what? Is reduced. I again reduce the number, the total time of completion of the project from 12 to 10. I shall find this shall be the total cost. I again reduce the total duration of the project from 10 to 8. I found now the cost is starting now increasing. Here was decreasing, decreasing, decreasing. At this level, it starts decreasing. Then I stop from there. Then I find the time duration that is allowable, I can crush the project. I can complete the project in 10 days and I incur this cost. How do I calculate these things today, as you said? I told you that we compute what we call the cost slope. The cost slope. Let me see if I show you the formula even there. This is one. You see that one? Are we together? Hello?
We are together.
This is now the one I said that we use, which is the cost slope, where you take the crash cost minus normal cost over normal time minus crash time. This is the information that is given there. It is already, it must be given like this. No more time, no more cost, crash cost. Then you gave me these numbers. These are the ones I differentiate. Let me go to the other table here. For example, here though I did not mention each and everything because sometimes when I teach you these things, I assume that my candidates are following. If they miss any class, then they missed much. For example, here I did not, in solving this one, I did not put I did not put all the critical activities there, are not put there. But if you had, if I detailed this one, maybe for the next time we can do, if you do not understand well, from A up to this one, I find what are the critical activities, is what I said, because we crush critical activities. And here I cannot say this is the critical, this is critical, this is critical, unless I use the other method to find the critical activities, and then the critical activities. Going to critical activities are the ones now I crush using this information. By crushing them, I use the same formula there, using the cost slope. The cost slope here is defined as the cost per unit time you reduce from the normal there. If it is the A, I shall go and use the other information there. I get from here the crushing time. If I get now, for example, like the crushing time, the allowable crushing here from the slope is, for example, 6 minus 2. It's like, okay, let me use this example, though I don't know whether B is critical or uncritical. Unless I can see maybe from the diagram, or I can use the RSS start or latest start. Now, assume that maybe B, I found it is critical. I now say, normal time is 6, crushing time is 4, then 6 minus 4 is 2. Are we together?
Yes.
Then I go to the cost. I have the normal cost, I have crushing cost. I take the crushing cost minus the normal cost. The difference I get from here, it is that the cost to reduce the normal duration of the project by 1 day. Now, since I have found here that is 2, 6 minus 2, is the one you shall find, for example, here. Like here. This one was 4 minus 2. If I go to this particular activity, I find it 2 and 4, let me go back, and I see that from the diagram, 2 and 4, it is this one, for example. 2 and 4, to mean that this activity was critical. Then it was this one minus this one is 2. Then I differentiate this one and this one. Then going there, you see, if I have 2, then is the one we used, for example, here. Then if I have this one was crushed by 1, 13, then minus 1, I get 12. Then from 12, I crushed by 2, then 2 is removed, I have now 10. Getting here, I have 2. This is the other normal cost. This is the crushing cost. To mean that this is 2, the 2 you are seeing here, times 50. This 50 is the cost per crushing 1 day. That's why I multiplied it by 2. To mean that this 50, let me go and we check where 50 was from. You can find it from the other columns there, which is this one, 50. Where is it, 50? Let me see, for example, let me take this one. Let's try to work out this one. 240 minus 100, that is, are we together?
Still together.
Here I'm applying the other formula there, this one. I want you to apply this formula. Crush cost minus normal cost over normal time minus crushing time is the one I'm applying from there, from this table, is the formula I'm using. The result I get from this formula, this one, is the one I multiply by the other numbers from this table there, these ones. These are variable, these ones that I have found from the difference. That the ones I'm multiplying by this one. This one, it is where it is came from. This one, it is where it came from. And this one times this one, where it came from, so that it came up with the total. The indirect cost, they came, these ones. This one was corresponding to 13. When you go to 12, when you want to complete the project in 12 days, I go to the indirect cost, you find it is 250. Let me go to 12. 12, it is this one. If you go to 10, you find it is 100. If you want to complete your project in 10 days, you add now 100. That is, and so on. Then you find the total cost of project. I don't know the way I can go through this way. I did not prepare it so that I can show it and everything. To say this one in the words, I don't know if you can pick it as I want. I will normally, but what I can do, if you wish, I can prepare this one and I include it in the other slide I shared you. I wanted to share, I shared you earlier, and I try to explain you how you can crush your project if you want to crush the projects. So I think you can maybe ask any other question if you have. Any other questions?
I hope there is no other question.
You have another question?
No, for me, there's no question.
So for this one, for crushing the other lady who raised this one, I did not prepare it because I did not see this one from the program. Normally, you are not supposed to crush the project, but if the leaf is there, especially this one, this item, I can hear you when it put even some explanations that one can even go through and try to solve any other problems from those past papers. So if there is no any other question, can we stop from here?
we can stop from here if there's another question.
Thank you for your time.
We
have to prepare our exam.
There are no any other questions. And what I wish, I shall try to include this one in the previous slide, and I I told them it will be better for me and most especially for you if they allow us two other sessions and we get to discuss another five chapters. And for the last session, I allocated all probability, all issues related to probabilities. So we shall communicate if the, or we can even, this is all about Zoom. We can even, we can request them to organize another session as long as you are available and they told you to get me area so that you can be ready for it and you complete the module like that. Or, me, I can say bye-bye.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.